الله أكبر الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع، ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، فصلوات الله وسلامه على رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على خير خلقه وأفضل رسله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين وعلى صحابته الغر الميامين وعلى التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، آية في كتاب الله عظيمة جدا كباقي الآيات. One great ayah as other ayat in the Quran all great. In Surah Al-Hadid. And this ayah, very amazing, very interesting. Shows how far and how close we are in our practical life to the purpose of our creation and our deen and faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hadid, ayah 25. Surah Al-Hadid, ayah number 25. الله سيد لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. ليقوم الناس بالقسط. Why Allah سبحانه وتعالى send the messengers? Why? Allah explained here in this ayah. Why Allah سبحانه وتعالى send the messages? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah brought the book down to us, send the book down to us. Al-Kitab. Why? Why this Quran? Why the Torah before the Quran? Why the Injil before the Quran? This ayah should ask why. And this ayah actually is cool for us. Some people, they think, if we pray, finish. Our job done. If we pay the zakah, our job done. If we do hajj, our job done. But indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to tell us in this ayah that your prayer is for you, for the akhirah, for the hereafter. All the good deeds that you do as individual is for you, for your judgment in the day of judgment. But there is something Allah meant for this life, for this world. And listen to the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقَسْطَ. To establish the justice and fairness. To be fair. To be truthful. To be honest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to establish the morals and akhlaq in the earth. And the morals and akhlaq and fairness has nothing to do with the ibadah in terms of the ummahat al-ibadat, the mothers of the worship acts. Like prayers, going for hajj. This has nothing to do with fairness. These are things that we do for ourselves, to better ourselves, to improve ourselves internally and externally and physically and mentally. But the way of life that Allah wants us to have, the attitude that Allah wants us to have, is to be fair. To be fair. So our topic today, how we can be fair, so we can fulfill the purpose of why this book, the Quran, sent to us. That means we are receiving the book. We are receiving the book and practicing it. Brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُنُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ. All those people who have the iman, those people of iman, who believe, كُنُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ, in this ayah. Be fair even if it is against yourself. Be fair if it is against even your own parents. أو الوالدين والأقربين. Even if it is against your own family. Even if it is against your own tribe. Even if it is against your own nationality or country. Brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be free from the illnesses of cultures, illnesses of tribalism, illnesses of family, attachment. Not because he's my brother, whatever he does is right. Not because he's my father, all what he does is right. This is not fair. What is right is right, what is wrong, regardless to who did it. We judge people based on the action, not based on the title. I know who you are, not from who you are, but from what you say, what you do. Brothers in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is something very interesting. He said, why those people before us, they were in trouble? Why those nations before us, they were in trouble? Allah destroyed them, even though they were chosen. They were the best nations. Allah sent them the kitab. Allah sent them the kitab for the purpose of fairness. But what they did, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا أَهْلَكَ الَّذِينَ قَبْلَكُمْ أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا إِذَا سَرَقَ فِيهُمُ الشَّرِيفُ تَرَكُوهُ وَإِذَا سَرَقَ فِيهُمُ الضَّعِيفُ أَقَامُوا عَلَيْهِ الْحَدَّ. وَأَيْمَ اللَّهِ لَوْ أَنَّ فَاطِمَ بِنْتُ مُحَمَّدْ سَرَقَتْ لَقَطَعَتْ يَدَهَا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the problem with those people before you, who got the book, who got the Allah gave them preferences, Allah chose them, chosen nations. But they used to be, when the person who has money or wealth or honor or position or from certain family or tribe, he steal, they leave him. If he does a crime, they leave him. Because he belonged to a certain family, or belonged to a certain tribe, or belonged to certain people. But if a weak person, a poor person, a simple person, a person who has nothing, person doesn't have a great family to support, doesn't have a great tribe to stand for him, if he does a mistake or a crime, they will implement the law. At that moment, the fairness comes, the justice comes, and the law comes. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is why they were destroyed. So this ummah is destroyed now. There is no respect, there is no honor. This ummah is separated everywhere, and they are not working together. They are disunited. Actually, they are fighting each other. Because they are not fair with each other. They do not say, even though I don't like this person, but what he said is right. We don't hear this. We don't say, listen, brother, I tell you the truth. He is my enemy, but what's it? He said yesterday is right. It's true. He's my enemy. Because he's the enemy of Allah. He's the enemy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because he is fighting Islam and Muslims. He's my enemy. But what he said yesterday is true. We don't hear this. Look what Allah said in the Quran. Amazing. Look. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم الا تعدل اعدلوا هو اقرب للتقوى. If you don't like certain people, or if you have enmity or war with certain people, if you don't like certain people, this should not drive you and make you unfair with them. when you talk about them, when you deal with them. Be fair, and this is close to the taqwa, the piety, the righteousness. Brothers in Islam, if you look at this ayat, very powerful ayat. Very, very powerful. He's not Muslim, but he's better than me. He's more organized. He's more hardworking. He's not lazy. He's more careful. He's this. Of course, I hate the kufr in him. I hate the shirk in him. I hate the kabaya that he does. I hate many things this person doing. But there are certain things he's better than me in this. And I have to be fair. And when I speak about him, I don't put him all in the rubbish bin. But I say there are certain things I don't like. There are certain things contradict with my Islam, with my deen, with my aqidah. But at the same time, I have to be fair. If one Muslim and non-Muslim, they had a dispute, and the non-Muslim comes to the mosque, say, oh Muslims, oh Imam, oh mosque committee, oh people of congregation, this Muslim did so and so to me. He insulted me. He damaged my car. He blocked my entrance. This person, he cheated me. He lied to me. We made partnership business together. And he put the information at the beginning. I trusted him. I thought he's faithful. But look, it's all lying. He took lots of money from me without any fairness or justification. Please help me. Muslims should stand with the non-Muslim in that case. Even though we don't like the kufr, we don't like the shirk. But Allah said to us, you have to be fair. You have to be fair. And to be fair, it doesn't mean. To be fair is to support your brother all the time, if he's wrong or right. To be fair is to support your brother if he is right only. And to stand against his evil if he is wrong. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أنصر أخاك ظالما أو مظلوما. Support your brother, stand with your brother if he is oppressed or he is oppressor. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said, Ya Rasulullah, we understand we can support our brother if he is oppressed. We can stand with him against the oppression. But how we can support him if he is oppressor? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تمنعه من الظلم. To stop his oppression, to stop his zulm, to stop his evil. That means you are stopping him against his false desire. Brothers in Islam, we need to be fair. We need to be fair with ourselves. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has right on you. Your family have right on you. Your certain, your even nafs, your body, yourself. It's right on you. So you have to be fair and give everyone the rights. We have to be fair with our parents, brothers in Islam. Some people, if their parents, they did one mistake, they don't forgive them. Now the case is upside down. The parents, they are doing good all the life. But then maybe a parent made one mistake. Then the son said, he's not my dad anymore. I'm not going to speak to him at all. Huh? What is this? We have to be fair. They have been all their life for us. They are not perfect. They are not angels. They do mistakes. And if we suffer because of their mistakes, we still have to be fair. And be friend with them. And not judging them because one mistake. Same thing. Our children is not our property. Our children, the creation of Allah. We look after them. We want the best for them. But then sometimes they do mistakes. We should not tell them, you are not my son anymore. You are not my daughter anymore. We should be kind and merciful. And be fair. They have been good. They have been good. We should give them chances and opportunities. We should bring them in and closer. And forgive them. And not every time we talk, we remind them their mistakes. It's like a CD player. CD player. Every time the family discuss, they bring all the history. all the history. You did this and this and this and this. Do you remember that? Brother, Allahu Akbar, this is 15 years ago. Why are you putting it here? And we keep reminding each other. We have to be fair. What happened, happened. The person recognized his mistake. The person said, I am sorry and apologized. We should turn the page and learn how to turn the page and let things go. And forgive for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if we let things go, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also forgive things for us. If we are kind, Allah will be more kind to us. If we are merciful, Allah will be more merciful to us. Brothers in Islam. We need to learn from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam life. How he was fair with all his sahaba regardless to their background and tribes. We should deal with people as people. We should love Muslims because they are Muslims. It doesn't matter where he is from, what is his tribe, his nationality, what type of passport he has. We should deal with him. This is Islam. This is Islam, brothers. If we see a Muslim, you should have in your heart the respect of this Muslim. And you should not, never ever, think that you are better than this Muslim. In any way. In fact, we should feel that everyone better than us. If somebody has a problem, this is even actually part of the entire Islam. If somebody has a problem, we should say, maybe Allah is testing this person because he has a strong iman. إِذَا حَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا ابْتَلَاهُ. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if Allah loves somebody, he will give him more tests, to get more iman and get more reward and more ranks in paradise. But if we have a trouble, we should say that Allah is giving us signs and signals to behave ourselves. This is the attitude in Islam. Be fair with people. Brothers in Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who are fair with their families, with themselves, with others, with Muslim, with non-Muslim, within our community and other communities. Brothers in Islam, the justice and fairness is key for the success. To the extent, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahmatullah alayhi, he said one great statement. We should actually write it with letters of noor. I don't want to see gold because we don't want to waste the gold. Right. Brothers, because I am against people who write things in gold and decorate in gold and put things in gold, even people who write Quran in gold. Because Israf is not part of Islam. But let's come back to this statement. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the victory of the non-Muslim nation, the nation of kufr and disbelief, against the nation of iman and belief, because they are more fair. And I'm going to put full stop and keep you and leave you to think and reflect for the reality of Muslims nowadays and their countries and their nations. Who's fair and who's not fair? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save all of us. قُلْ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَيَا فَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ. إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنُصَلِّي وَنُسَلِّمُ عَلَى رَسُولِهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، يا أحباب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، يا من منحكم الله الإيمان وهي أعظم نعمة أعطاكم الله سبحانه وتعالى. There is another thing related. I am talking to myself and to every single one. So don't feel you are targeted. I'm targeted even myself. أيها الإخوة, there is something I have been suffering from because I observe it and I see it. And I know it's very critical and I know it's very dangerous. A person to be a religious person. Religious person. He's praying, he's doing all this ibadat and mashallah. Great example. But you go to his house, you see his wife suffering from him. His daughter suffering from him. His son suffering from him. his parents suffering from. He neglecting his old parents. He's bad to his name. He's so bad to one of his friends. This is something I see, and even I'm suffering to see all the time among the Muslims, Ummah and community, and even those people who are close to me, in terms of relatives, in terms of neighbors, in terms of members of congregation. And I feel this is something that destroying the Muslim Ummah. That we have two faces. Faces in terms of the ibadat, and this is very nice and shining and good. Another face in terms of mu'amalat, the transaction, the morals, how we deal with others. And brothers in Islam, I'm not scaring you, but I'm telling you the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment will forgive everything, but the rights of others will not be forgiven. And it's not my words. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدواوين ثلاثة. This famous hadith, الدواوين ثلاثة. The records in the Day of Judgment, three. There's one record Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and doesn't care about. And these are the rights of Allah. If the person comes with iman and tawheed, if the person has the faith, and even little deep, but the person submit to the will of Allah, the person accept Allah as his Lord, at the end, what the Prophet said, this the one Allah will forgive it as whole, because it has the iman. And another, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at it, big crimes, major sins, based on the mashi'a of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah forgives some, Allah doesn't forgive some, and there are judgment. But then, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is the one, this record, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't forgive. Which is حقوق العباد, the rights of others. This has to be taken with justice. The person have to pay from his own deeds and credits. And if he doesn't, then those people who have lots of bad deeds, they will bring their bad deeds to him. So the fairness will be, and the justice and the exchange will be, is the hasanat and sayyi'at. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ الظُّلْمَ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ وَجَعَلَهُ بَيْنَكُمْ مُحَرَّمًا فَلَا تَظَلَمُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the operation even haram on himself. Allah made it haram on you, so do not make dhulm. So we should not make dhulm in ourselves or people around us. Brothers in Islam, at the end of my khutbah, I would like to remind you with the coming days and weeks. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us another gift, the season of Hajj coming. The season of Hajj coming, لبيك اللهم لبيك. لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة والملك لا شريك لك. Brothers, this is a great time for Muslim nation as well. We need to encourage each other to go and encourage others and also support others. And one thing I would like to share with you is these great days coming, the day of Arafah, the best day in the whole year coming, and inshallah ayamul al-ashra from the Hijjah coming. The first 10 days of the Hijjah coming as well very soon. And the day of Eid coming as well very soon. I want to highlight one important thing. Many of us, they made Hajj. But maybe their parents didn't make. Maybe their grandparents didn't. And part of our kindness and fairness and goodness toward them, we should make Hajj for them. Or sponsor somebody to make Hajj for them. This is very important, because if somebody did Hajj, which is important, he has to do for himself first, Hajjatul Islam, then this person can do for his parents. He can do for his father or mother or grandfather or grandmother on their behalf. If they are so ill in their deathbed, they are very old, they cannot go, or if they are dead already. Brothers in Islam, this making Hajj for the parents is very great kindness that will pay little of what they have done for us. And we should not even stay and live comfortable if our parents or grandparents didn't do Hajj. We should hasten for this great deed, arranging Hajj for our parents and grandparents if we did for ourselves already. And if we didn't, we should do for ourselves. And we don't have to do it ourselves, we can sponsor somebody that we trust his piety and his taqwa to do Hajj for our parents. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us Hajj and Mabrooran and our parents. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala Ibrahim. إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعنا على أنفسنا بفعل الطاعات وترك المنكرات. اللهم أحينا مسلمين وتوفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك ولا تجعلنا عن ذكرك من الغافلين. اللهم ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم إنا نسألك لوالدينا جنات الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. اللهم ارحمنا وارحم المسلمين أجمعين. اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم أنزل سكناتك ومحبتك ورحمتك على المسلمين أجمعين يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعلنا من المحسنين. اللهم اجعلنا من المحسنين. اللهم اجعلنا من المحسنين. اللهم يا ربنا ويا حبيبنا ويا مولانا اجعلنا من المخلصين من الصادقين. اللهم وطهر قلوبنا من النفاق والرياء والشقاق وسوء الأخلاق واهدنا إلى أحسنها فإنه لا يهدي إلى أحسنها إلا أنت برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.